In this experiment, we're going to see the result of chlorination and dechlorination. We're going to start out with 16 pouches of raw lake water. This is the lake water to a power plant in Texas. Notice that the pouches are labeled 0, 2, 4, and 8. That stands for milligrams per liter of chlorine, free chlorine. So 0 means this is raw lake water. And into these pouches, we're going to add 2 milligrams per liter of free chlorine into this pouch, 4 milligrams per liter of free chlorine, and these pouches, 8 milligrams per liter of free chlorine. So once the raw water has been placed into a pouch, then the appropriate amount of Clorox solution, sodium hypochlorite, is added to get the correct free residual of chlorine. In order to verify that the correct amount of free chlorine has been added to the pouch, a DR2000 spectrophotometer was used. After reagents are placed into the solution, a color is formed. The cuvette is then placed inside of the spectrophotometer, and the free chlorine residual is measured. The free chlorine residual has to be less than 2 milligrams per liter to show up on the DR2000, so correct dilutions are made. And in this case, this is an 8 milligram per liter solution that's been diluted 1/8. So we see that the readout is 1.07, so very close to 8 milligrams per liter of free chlorine. After the chlorine is added to the pouches, then the chlorine is allowed to work for 7 hours. So in 7 hours, the organic material inside of these pouches are being worked on by the free chlorine residual. At the end of 7 hours, sodium bisulfite is added to dechlorinate to a free residual of 0. So at this point, all the bags then have a 0 free chlorine residual. Now into each bag, 1 milliliter of raw water, in other words, lake water, 1 milliliter of lake water is added to each bag. The bags are then placed into an incubator for 48 hours at 30 degrees Celsius. At the end of 48 hours, the bacteria which grew in each bag were counted using a standard plate count method, starting out with solid agar, which is then boiled and liquefied. Once liquefied, it's then cooled in a water bath, and what we're looking at here is a water bath where the liquid hot agar is cooled down to around 112 to 114 degrees Fahrenheit. From each of the bags, a 1/10 milliliter or 1 milliliter of solution is placed into a Petri dish. 15 milliliters of agar is added to the Petri dish. The bacteria and agar are then swirled to mix them thoroughly. Once all of the Petri dishes have been prepared, they're then placed into an incubator where they're incubated for 48 hours at 30 degrees Celsius. What we're looking at here is the number of bacteria that have grown in raw lake water. The lake water has been diluted 1 to 100. So we're seeing the number of bacteria that have grown in 1 milliliter of 1 to 100 diluted lake water. Notice the difference in the number of bacteria which could grow in raw lake water versus here, where we see the number of bacteria which grew after 7 hours of 2 milligram per liter of free chlorine and then subsequently dechlorinated. And here's the result of 4 milligrams per liter of free chlorine followed by dechlorination. And finally, we see the result of 8 milligram per liter of free chlorine followed by dechlorination. To summarize, we're going to look at 2 Petri dishes. Both of them will be 1 milliliter of 1 to 1,000 dilution. Now in this Petri dish, we're looking at raw lake water, 1 to 1,000. There are virtually no colonies formed. Here's the result of the same water, except 2 milligram per liter of chlorine worked on the organic material in the water for 7 hours, and then it was dechlorinated. and look at the number of colonies that have formed.